Ronald, what approach do you take to grow your business? And how was the business for you in the last 6 to 8 months?
So sports in general is kind of an interesting one, right? Because it's a participatory thing and you need people to be able to do it. So bowling being an indoor sport has definitely seen a lot of contraction as a result of the pandemic. You know, when states closed down, people aren't really going bowling. We've been very lucky with our situation just because of the way we go to market. The industry is kind of set up to kind of go from a manufacturer to a distributor to a pro shop to a consumer. And that's just the way all of the businesses in bowling tend to work. When we started this company 5 years ago, we opted to go the opposite way. We went from manufacturer directly to consumer and then built up that business enough to where pro shops said, how can we get involved? So we developed a program for them, built that up enough where distributors said, how can we get involved? And did the same thing with them. So when everything shut down, whereas a lot of the manufacturers had nowhere to be able to go because they couldn't send to distribution because distribution was also shut down, we were still able to send product to people, still able to sell product because we talked directly to consumers. And not all of the consumers were done bowling. Not only that, but one of the other things that we've been able to do, it's a little bit different. Using the Shopify platform, we use an app called Bold, which is a subscription app. And we offer subscriptions to people to get our products on a monthly basis. And that was very interesting for our brand because it allowed us to get continual income even when there was nobody bowling. So that was very helpful for us. And then we also have a thing that we do where we basically, because we give away all of our information in terms of information about bowling, we've got a staffing program where you can kind of become an ambassador or a brand ambassador for us. And it gets you into a group and gets you into getting some inside information and those kind of things. And we always interact with our group. And when the pandemic hit, we actually kind of pivoted a little bit from just giving raw information to changing to do some entertaining stuff. So we actually started playing online games with our staff group. And we found that to be very helpful, uplifting, considering that everybody was kind of stuck at home one. And then the more interesting thing with that is we did a couple of sales during March and April, which is when the pandemic was going on. And we actually had two of our best months ever during that time period. I think it's a combination of because we were continuing to interact with people, whereas kind of everybody else, at least in our industry, kind of shut down. Like they completely shut down and weren't really doing much of anything. So there wasn't a whole lot of options. And the fact that we had built a kind of a repertoire with the people to be able to interact with them on a continual basis. So it was like, well, I've got some money here and bowling will eventually come back. So let me go spend it with you guys. So
Excellent.
it actually for us, it ended up being a kind of a good thing just because our business model is a little bit different than everybody else's.